Hello, my name is Karen Edwards and I'm a storyteller from Carnlough in the Glens of Antrim. The story I'm going to tell you now I got from a man called Harry Scott from Tullycarnet Yarn Spinners, and it's about a widow woman called Grace Rainey. Grace was a yarn spinner and she spun thread into balls of the finest yarn that you can imagine. People would come from all over to buy Grace's yarn. And if anyone had a suit that was woven with Grace's thread, it was, "This suit is made with thread from the widow Rainey." So much in demand was the yarn that Grace spun that she had to sit late at night till long after midnight spinning her yarn. Grace was also a midwife, so sometimes people would call on her at strange hours of the day and night. And one night, it was a wicked night, when the sea was howling and the wind was howling round the windows, Grace heard a knock at the door. She went over, she opened it, and there stood a tall woman, a dark-skinned woman with a long flowing black cloak and a hood over her head. "Come with me now, we have need of you." "Who has need of you? I don't know you." "Come with me now, and it will be to your advantage." So Grace went back into the house. She put the fire guard up. She set down her yarn. She took up her shawl and she threw it around her, and out she went out the door, closing the door behind her. She took the arm of the dark-skinned woman and they flew over hedges and ditches and ways and fields that Grace had never seen before. And then they sat down at a place known as Dan's Fort. And there, in the side of the fort, in the shape of a door, were the strangest twinkling lights that Grace had ever seen. They went through the door, and the room inside was filled with the fairy folk. They were dancing and drinking and making merry. And there, right in the centre, on a sort of a chaise longue, was a young woman in the throes of labour. Grace went straight over. She set down her shawl. She helped that young woman deliver the bonniest baby boy you've ever seen. His cheeks were as fat as butter. He was a beauty. When it was finished, Grace took her shawl up again. She left the room. She took the arm of the dark-skinned woman and they flew black back over the countryside and landed right outside Grace's cottage. "Never breathe a word of this to anyone, or you will lose your advantage." Grace had no doubt that what she said was true. When she went into the house, she couldn't believe her eyes. All the yarn that Grace had left unspun was spun into balls of the finest golden thread that you have ever seen. From that day on, Grace was able to go to bed at a reasonable hour. She didn't have to sit late spinning her yarn. And the next morning she would come down and there wouldn't it all be spun by the fairy folk, of course. Now, Grace was a wee bit of a tittle-tattle and she couldn't resist breathing a word of this to her friend Elsie. She just told her a little of what had happened, but Elsie had a great idea. "I tell you what, I'll bring my yarn down too, and maybe the fairies will spin my yarn as well, and then I won't have to sit late at night working." And I tried that, but of course, the fairies were too smart for the pair of women. And when Grace came down in the morning, only her yarn was spun. And she knew that if she breathed another word, that she would lose her advantage. And that's why you should never play fast and loose with the fairies. And now I'm going to play you a little tune called the Fairy Hornpipe. Thank you. Thank you.